Good morning, everyone. How are you doing? I just woke up. It's 12:37. Woke up like 40 minutes ago. And I know the Acolyte trailer came out, so we're going to go ahead and watch it for the first time. Haven't seen it yet. I hope you like my little AI thumbnail. Four hours ago, 1.5 mil. Let's go ahead and start. Well, everyone's coming in now. Up 1600 people. Just in a minute. What up? 1700. What's going on, guys? Make sure to hit the like button. Theory Saber's website launching very soon. You're gonna have everything you could possibly desire.
Everything and more, master.
Okay, so was it good or was it bad? I haven't seen it yet. For those dropping in. We're gonna answer the super chats before we watch it. Hey, why do you keep saying the show must have or mention Plagueis when based on Legends? He's only about 15 years old during the series. Do the math. No, isn't this series 50 years before The Phantom Menace, which would make him, is that 65? He was about 115, 120 when he died, so, originally the show was supposed to be 200 years before, I think, which means that he wouldn't be alive, but his masters would be. So, I don't know why you would have a problem with the lore, man. You got to know the lore. So, if it's 50 years before, then he's very much alive. If it's 100 years before, then, yeah, he would be 15. So, depends on when the show takes place. I don't really know. Theory, I'm so triggered. You have helped me. Why would Papa George openly back Bob Iger and his board members by saying magic can't be made? What? What do you mean? This left a bad taste in my mouth. Visually looks great. Really looks like it's going to break canon. Theory, I anticipate a bloodbath of the Jedi by those trained in the dark side, dark arts of the Force, so that once more the Sith shall rule the galaxy. This show is 100 years prior to the Phantom Menace. Plagueis being there wouldn't make sense. Quit looking for things to hate.
What?
What do you mean looking for things to hate? All right, well, if he's not around, then his master has to be. And this isn't this 50 years before? Or is it 100? Anyways. What's up, Rossi? Been waiting for this trailer review. All right, cool. We got 2,500 people in the stream. Let's hit it. 2,600.
Crazy.
All right. I'm going to share this on Twitter. Okay. I'm going to put this on Instagram. I always like to do this stuff live with you. It gives you like a bit of a more honest look at what it's like like YouTubing. Alrighty. Give me about 12 seconds and then we'll hit play. All right. Okay. 3,013 people. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Everyone hit that like button. Get this on the trending page. It'd be sick. All right. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The Acolyte.
Close your eyes. Your eyes can deceive you. We must not trust them. Tell me what comes into your mind.
Life. Balance. I see fire.
Fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
Oh, shit, okay. Run it back one more time.
Close your eyes. Your eyes can deceive you. We must not trust them. Tell me what comes into your mind.
Life. Balance.
I see fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
Alright, first impressions. I mean, I know everyone wants me to have, like, a verdict right away from a trailer. I can't have a verdict right away from a trailer. The thing is, there's nothing to attach it to. It's not like I can, you know, it's not like the Skywalker saga where I could be like, okay, yeah, like, this makes sense or it doesn't make sense. Like, this is a totally different time. First impressions, I mean, I'm not, like, blown away, but I don't think it's crap. There's really not much to tell. Like, I don't know. Premise, someone's killing Jedi. It's kind of like a murder mystery. The Jedi are probably like, what the heck is going on, since we haven't seen a Sith in 1,000 years. Or 950 years. Does this take place 100 years or 50 years before The Phantom Menace? Because they keep changing it around. I remember originally it was like 200 years. And then they changed it, I think, to like... I thought it was 50. But if it's 100, then yeah, Plagueis wouldn't make sense. But Tenebris. Yeah, I mean... I don't know, there's not... like. It's so hard doing these trailers sometimes because it's like, I know everyone wants me to be like, it's shit! Or everyone wants me to be like, it's amazing! I can't tell, so I'm pretty neutral right now. You know what I mean? You know what? I'll be very honest with you. I'm not really feeling... Something feels like it's just like a generic sort of, it's trying to be dark and mysterious, but I'm not... And again, it's hard for me to say anything because it's just a trailer. Like, how much can I get from something from like a minute and 45 seconds? This scene took me out. I'll tell you that much. Where is it? This. That took me out. I don't know. This just doesn't sell it for me. For whatever reason. I think the costumes just look cheap. Seems cool. Bunch of younglings training. It's nice. Market. See? Alright, one alien. What? Okay. All right, Jedi Temple Coruscant. Is this the same room from Obi-Wan? at least this one doesn't look so confined. So who's this? Is she the Sith? This June.
Jedi. Doesn't make sense.
I don't know. A lot of these actors, man, they just look like typical people from. Well, I guess kind of humans, but I don't know why I'm not getting. I don't know why I'm not getting this otherworldly feel for it.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
Bro, like I don't want to hate on anything. It's a trailer. Like, what am I supposed to say? But I don't know, dude. Something just feels weird.
This isn't about.
You know why I think? Okay, here's why I think it's weird. Here's why I think it feels weird. It's because it's unfamiliar. It's a totally different time, but it's using something familiar like Jedi. That's why it feels weird. Because we know the Jedi like the back of our hands. But this is a time where they're different. That's why I'm not making the connection. Okay. Yeah, fair enough. Hey, you know, nothing I can say, man. It's a totally, I gotta let the show play out. What is this, Arc 2? Bro, this is Arc 2. This Arc 2? Everyone wants you to say what? Everyone wants you to say woke wars?
No, I'll call something out when it's woke. When it's woke,
I can't tell from a trailer. So I think Leslie Headland has made some whack remarks. Yeah, for sure. I don't agree with any of them, really, but... You know, there's been directors with Star Wars that I agreed with a lot of what they said, and then they made a film that I didn't agree with at all. I mean, I'll watch it, but right now I'm not like, holy shit! But again, this is, I think, really the first time that we have a new project about the Jedi that doesn't have to do with the Skywalker timeline. So it's a weird feeling. It's different. It's definitely different. Right off the bat, I'll say I think there's too many humans. Immediately. Way too many humans. So far. And I feel like the actors are too famous. Like this dude, I don't know where I've seen him from, but I've seen him many times before. I like Carrie Ann Moss, she's cool, but you know, again, like very famous. Okay, so they sense some sort of Sith, I suppose. Okay, but like, what's the deal? So what? Tenebris can't sense the darkness? Tenebris ain't around? This is one sect of the galaxy somewhere, like the main sect with all the Jedi. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? Let's do a poll. Got 5,000 people in the chat, just about. Did you like it? I'll tell you what I thought was cool, though. The part with the Force. That's pretty cool. Like get effed. Get out of here. I mean, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, well. Play my issue with this scene right here. All right, way too many humans in one frame. In each frame, you got to have aliens. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's not a single alien in this frame.
Can deceive you.
I mean, the master himself. There you go. There's one alien. But I'd say it's got to be like 50-50, bro. Like, this is... God, it's going to turn into a bricks and screws situation.
Trust them.
Not enough aliens! Yeah, you're damn right. Not enough aliens. Look at this. Okay. Is that a guy? What, one guy? One guy in this frame? Oh, that's a woman. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Humans. All humans. In the like, we need some aliens, man. What, this dude's wearing a mask? Is he an alien? 15.
Tell me.
Okay, let me see this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So out of 12, you have two aliens? Nah, bro. Come on. Let me show you something. Let me show you something real quick. We're splitting hairs here. We're splitting peas. Check this out. Look, alien, droid, human. Human, human, human. All right. Alien. I can't really tell.
Younglings. Younglings. A visitor we have.
Hello. I'm sorry to disturb you, Master. The archive maps.
Lost a planet, Master Obi-Wan has.
How embarrassing.
How embarrassing. Liam, the shades. Gather round the map reader, clear your minds, and find Obi-Wan's wayward planet we will.
It ought to be pulling...
But the star and all the planets disappeared they have. How can this be? A thought? Anyone?
Master?
Because someone erased it from the archive memory.
Truly wonderful the mind of a child is.
The Padawan is right. Go to the center of gravity's pull and find your planet. You will.
Okay, well, now we're just watching Attack of the Clones. I always get sucked in like a vortex. Every time. Dude, it's like when I'm doing research sometimes on videos, I'm like, oh, yeah, let me go and research something real quick from the prequels. I end up watching it because it's spending all my time. Just Star Wars community trying to find things to hate. Why do you look at it like that? Like, that just kind of screams to me that you must be a person that really just accepts everything. You know, Star Wars is really important to a lot of us. Not to a lot of Weekend Warrior Star Wars fans, and that's fine. But to a lot of us, you know, this is really important stuff. So, yeah, look, hey, I'm not here to just watch this trailer and be like, no, bro, let's go into it. Let's have some fun. Let's dive in. Be like, hey, like, what are we looking at here? How do I feel compared to the previous stuff? And so far, I'm not like super heavily invested, but hey, I'm happy that we get some sort of a show about the Force and Jedi. You know, if you came here to find me rip it apart, I'm sorry. I can't do that until I watch the whole thing. I just don't think that would be really honest of me. Okay, so this chick's a Jedi. All right. So I was kind of confused. I was like, well, maybe she's just wearing the clothes of a Jedi and she looks kind of evil a little bit. So what, a darkness rises in like an, I guess a Sith. Or just a dark... So, the premise apparently, from a rumor, I don't know if this is real or a leak or whatever, that there's a village, you guys might have heard me talk about this for anyone new here, and if you're new here, let me know in the chat. There's a village that gets raided by bad guys. Jedi come in, they want to take one of the Force sensitive children of the village. The village makes a deal, says, okay, you can have the child if you protect our village from the bad guys that come in every once in a blue moon. And they're like, yeah, sure, we'll help you. They don't help. The village gets ransacked. There's one survivor. It's the sibling of the Force sensitive child that gets taken. And then she vows to kill all the Jedi because she hates them for not abiding by their their plan that they had, their deal. And she turns evil and she's extremely powerful and all this and that. So I'm wondering if that person is Kate Moss. Is it Kate Moss or Carrie Ann Moss? I'm wondering if that's her. Or maybe she is sent from the Jedi to go and figure out, like, who is killing everybody. Theory sounds a little woke, talking about there's not enough aliens. I sound woke saying there's not enough aliens in Star Wars. Jesus. Huge super chat from Devlin. What's going on? Also, from a small business owner like myself to another, dump this money into Theory Sabers, and I'll be buying one soon as full site launches. Much love, brother. Much love, man. Thank you so much, dude. That means a lot. I appreciate it. Did you guys know if you send super chats off of your iPhone that I think I only get like 40%? Anyways, I appreciate it. If you do it on your computer, there isn't that. There's like a 30 cent charge on YouTube and then another 30% on Apple. It's crazy. I was looking, I'm like, how is this happening? Sucking up your money, man. This left a bad taste in my mouth. Visually looks great, but really looks like it's going to break canon. See, that's the thing. Will this break canon? Is that it takes place in a time that our canon doesn't really exist. I just look at 1-6. This is before. So, if Plagueis ain't around, if this is 100 years before, then his masters are around. And I guess they're on their own journey, and this is just looking at this one little facet that's going on. Theory, I anticipate a bloodbath of Jedi by those trained in the dark arts of the Force, so that once more the Sith shall rule the galaxy. This show is 100 years prior to the Phantom Menace. Plagueis being there wouldn't make sense. Yeah, it wouldn't make sense if it's 100 years. But it's 50 years, it would make sense. Isn't Plagueis a child or not born at this point? Again, I don't know when it takes place. Been waiting for this trailer review. Hey, brother, so happy to catch a live stream while at work. I'm more than happy to support your efforts via Super Chats or Donos. You're a great guy. Thank you, brother. Thanks, dude. Doing my best. Today, George openly backed Bob Iger and his board. Google it. Did he? What do you mean? George Lucas backs Disney and Bob Iger in proxy fight. Creating magic is not for amateurs. What? Weren't you an amateur? Creating magic is not for amateurs. When I sold Lucasfilm just over a decade ago, I was delighted to become a Disney shareholder because of my longtime admiration for its iconic brand and Bob Iger's leadership. When Bob recently returned to the company during a difficult time, I was relieved. No one knows Disney better. I remain a significant shareholder because I have full faith and confidence in the power of Disney and Bob's track record to driving long-term value. I have voted all my shares for Disney's 12 directors and urged other shareholders to do this. Okay, so? Cheers. He's talking about Disney. He's a shareholder, bro. He's also a business guy at the end of the day. He has $4 billion, I think, in share. $2 billion in shares? In Disney shares? He's talking about Disney. He's not talking about Star Wars. When Bob recently returned during a difficult time, I was relieved. No one knows Disney better. Yeah, no one knows Disney better. It's not like he said no one knows Star Wars better. Who cares? He's looking at his stock options, bro. I remain a significant shareholder. Yeah, he's got a lot of stocks in Disney. I think he's got like what? It's got to be over 20, 30%. Yeah. Well, How do you guys take that? I'm a little surprised, actually, that he would be supporting him fully. See, like, on one angle, maybe he's just doing this as, like, a Disney thing, like a money thing. You can see the wheels spinning in my head. That's the way I look at it. It's not clear how much Disney stock Lucas owns, but when the company acquired Lucasfilm for $4 billion, the deal included about $1.8 billion in stock. Marvel, similarly, was acquired for about $4 billion. Disney has been aggressively pushing back against the activists. What do you mean? The activists in your own company that are, like, driving your movies to shit? Not only outlining a strategic game plan, but framing them as being more self-interested than pro-Disney? That is the most ridiculous statement. Disney has been aggressively pushing back against the activists. They're hiring them. What do you mean they're pushing back? They're fucking hiring them, giving them jobs. They're paying them. Are you kidding? What is that? Yeah, we've been pushing them so far back that they're coming around the corner and we're hiring them. Are you kidding? Yeah, okay. I don't know why he would back Bob Iger. But look, maybe I don't know the full details. Maybe this is like a I don't know, am I coping right now? Maybe it's like a Disney thing. Maybe it's just, what is this about? What is this whole thing about here? All right, the poll has 4,000 votes. 49% of people say that they like it. 51% say they don't. Yeah, I mean, man, it's just a little too early for me to even say anything. I gotta see a bunch of episodes here. So far, I'm like, eh. All right. It's whatever.
Lies can deceive you.
Wait, any bricks in this scene? No, we're good. All right.
We must not trust them.
It was that Batu.
Tell me what comes into your mind.
Life. Balance. I see fire.
Yeah, you know she's fucking dark as hell, man. Fire?
I see happy things. I see life. I see death and destruction. It's like, all right,
Tom Riddle, chill out.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
All right, who's that? This old guy. Proximo!
Killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
Okay, so obviously this dude's like a legend because he just force freezes the assassin. Whoever this is.
It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
2 episode premiere. Crazy. So yeah, let's see. What's the, hold on, we got the episode list somewhere here. Boom, 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 boom. Can someone tweet me the episode list? Right now, I'll bring it up. Get ready for 4K Erasure of Tenebris Plagueis Lore. Oh no, don't worry about it, bro. It only takes place 100 years before. Tenebris isn't around. Yeah, he is. Makes $8 billion on Star Wars, uses Raggedy Ann hair. Raggedy Ann hair. What's that? What do you think of the O in Acolyte being a ring? I think it's the ring Yoda gives Yaddle before clapping them green cheeks. Looks like Wokey dog turd theory. Star Wars meets The Matrix meets a samurai movie. That's kind of what it's like, yeah. Yeah. Plo Koon spotted at 55 seconds. No, I think that's just another... Yeah, like right there. I saw that too. Another Duros. Watch the trailer. Just doesn't have that Star Wars vibe we all know and love. Ever since Disney took over, it just feels off, but it could just be me. Yeah, it's not that it feels off. It just feels like it's something else. But also, it's hard for me to say anything because it's just a trailer. But it's also a trailer of another time. So, I mean, okay, you know what? Hold up. Murder mystery, I feel like that was kind of like Attack of the Clones with Padme. So let's go ahead and watch the original Attack of the Clones trailer. And just see how we feel. This is from 2002, all right? Immediately feels Star Wars. Sounds like the most simple trailer. And it's so sick. Look what I'm saying, though. Every scene feels like it's out of this world, right? I mean, when do you find a beautiful woman like this? That's out of this world. Like, come on. When do you find a beautiful man like that? That's out of this world. All right. Out of this world. Out of this world. Alien. Out of this world. And the each scene has a different kind of like color palette too. And that's, I think it's really important as well. You know, we're in Coruscant. We've got 2 Jedi with lightsabers. This dude seems concerned. There's no talking. Different world. Different world. Different world. Alien. Space. Different world. Droid, different world. Definitely a different world. Definitely a different world. What the heck's going on here? Action, army. I mean, you know. And that's what I think Star Wars felt like. It just felt different. I'm not doing this to shit on the Acolyte. I don't really care about the Acolyte right now. I'm just talking about the differences that I notice in Star Wars. And look, the Acolyte might be really great. There's not much we can tell from a trailer. You can get a sense of things. But, you know, right now, at least he's cute.
Close your eyes. Your eyes can deceive you. We must not trust them. Tell me what comes into your mind.
Life. Balance. I see fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
Harry Potter?
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power, and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
Like I said, Jedi are more strict back in the High Republic, or are they less strict than the Jedi during the prequel trilogy? I think that's a ring. Every shot is a close-up. Yeah, that's one thing that makes it feel kind of claustrophobic a little bit. Why are they using the Force to open doors? They had automatic over. Music sucks too. Listen, I think I'm one of the most critical people when it comes to Star Wars. And it means a lot to me. However, there isn't really much I can say from this trailer. Am I super invested and excited? No. Am I super turned off and like, nah, this is going to be shit? No. Like, all right, cool. It's a trailer. Let's wait and see what happens. I feel like it should make me really excited, but it's not. Since you guys hate it so much and stop watching it, let us enjoy it. Damn. What a weak comment. No one's letting you not enjoy something. Everyone's entitled to have an opinion, man. Watch the trailer. It just doesn't have that Star Wars vibe we all know and love. Ever since Disney took over, it just feels off, but it could just be me, says Eric. FYI, George praised Disney and Bob Iger. Not a many men or aliens in it. Yeah, no, there's not many men or aliens in it. I agree. As long as the Jedi that encounter the Sith die. That's kind of another thing, is that, yeah, all of the Jedi that see the Sith have to die. And all of the Sith have to die as well. So. Yeah. Avatar, The Last Acolyte, reserving judgment. All I have known my entire life is Star Wars, but this trailer makes me wish they would just stop trying and not make any more content. It's not Star Wars. Yeah, it doesn't really feel like Star Wars. And again, bro, like, I know there's thousands waiting for me to just, like, rip it apart. I think in order to be extremely authentic, I have to wait and watch the actual show. You know, with all of Leslie Headland's comments against George and the prequels and all that stuff, believe me, I'd love to rip it apart. But I'm really the type of guy that I'll wait and I'll observe and I'll watch, and then I'll make my judgments. But right now, there isn't really too much I can say about it because it's just, I'm like, all right, well, we'll see what it is. But that's not really how a trailer should leave you. A trailer should leave you like, holy shit, I am so invested. I want to watch more of this. But I'm not feeling that right now. But right off the bat, music, exciting. Different world.
I will not let this republic be.
Right, so that was the cool thing with the original Star Wars trailers, is that it would show right off the bat how expansive this is. Wide shots. Different worlds.
Split in two. My negotiations will not fail.
If they do, there aren't enough Jedi to protect the Republic.
Check this out. Royal Red Guards, out of this world. Alien. Dickhead. You know Ki-Adi-Mundi had four wives? And the Council let him have four wives? Because the species was going extinct. I wonder if the same is with Yoda.
Republic, we're keepers of the peace, not soldiers.
You know I don't like it when you do that.
Sorry, Master. I forgot you don't like flying. Well, you've lost him.
If you'll excuse me.
I hate it when he does that.
Anakin, don't do anything without first consulting either myself or the Council.
You don't need guidance, Anakin. I see you becoming the greatest of all Jedi.
The boy has exceptional skills.
His abilities have made him arrogant.
Excuse me. I'm in charge of security.
There was one trailer, man. I can't find it. I remember it when it came out, and like it was so cool, man. Is it this one? Oh, here's another one.
It's a great pleasure to see you again, lady.
It has been far too long, Master Kenobi. Annie? My goodness, you've grown.
So have you. You're more beautiful.
Just being around her again is intoxicating.
Be mindful of your thoughts, Anakin. They betray you. You have made a commitment.
Bro is like, I ain't mindful of anything, Obi-Wan. The only thing I'm mindful of is how hot Padme is.
The Jedi Order, a commitment not easily broken.
Please don't look at me like that.
Why not?
It makes me feel uncomfortable.
Toxic.
Sorry, m'lady.
Toxic. Bro, Annie would be canceled in a heartbeat. Could you imagine? She has Twitter right then and there. Maybe it's a new series I gotta make. If Star Wars characters had Twitter, right then and there, she goes to her closet. She's like, my Jedi protector just made me feel very uncomfortable. Someone send help. This is horrible. He probably, to be honest, he definitely did make her feel uncomfortable. Not gonna lie. And he probably would have been off the case. He probably would have been expelled from the Jedi Order. The Council would have probably gotten involved. And he's just like, the life of Anakin Skywalker now. He's what? Living on the streets of Coruscant? Game over, man. Would have been done. You know, shouldn't have looked at her that way. But that probably would have happened. That would have happened.
It'd be difficult having sworn your love to the Jedi. Not being able to do the things you like.
I'll be with the people that I love.
Are you allowed to love? Thought that was forbidden for a Jedi. You're making fun of me.
No, I'd be much too frightened to tease a senator. We could keep it a secret.
Be living a lie.
Okay. Yeah, when I was a kid, I remember watching this. I was 12 years old, and I was like, why would she wear that to tell him that she's not interested? I mean, that's just so mean, dude. Like, what the hell?
A lie. What the heck, man? That.
she's a politician. And they are not to be trusted.
I've heard this lesson before.
You haven't learned anything, Anakin.
It's all Obi-Wan's fault. He's holding me back.
You're not all powerful, Anakin.
Well, I should be. Someday I will be.
Bro, this is the coolest scene. I think in all of Star Wars, this is the coolest scene ever. Just epic. And that's the thing with these old trailers, that they all establish the world building, that this is an expansive world in a galaxy far, far away, by these wide screen shots of other worlds and different scenes. And they each have different colors, and look, there's one, there's another.
It was just before dawn, they
another.
Came out of nowhere.
Do you have any idea who's behind this attack?
We will find out who's trying to kill you, Padme. I promise you.
That's the thing, and this comes back to the actual brick and screws thing, which is, I know it's a meme, but every scene in the first six films feels like another place other than Earth. And that's something that was really important to Ralph McQuarrie. And I know this because I've spoken to the man who handled all of his artwork and took care of it all. And, you know, Paul Bateman. And he told me that one thing that Ralph was really, always really cognizant of was that every single frame has to look like it's part of another galaxy. I'm not talking about Acolyte. That's nothing to do with it. I'm just going on a tangent and having fun. Every single frame has to look like another part of Star Wars. And I'm sure Doug Chang took a lot of inspiration from that too. Another part of the galaxy. Another part of something that's not part of Earth.
To the moon. She'll be safer there.
I do not like this idea of hiding.
And if you look at it, it's really true. Every single scene, I mean, the architecture, you know, in the background, you got the city. It's just the buttons. Everything is different. And that's one of the things that really gives Star Wars this extraterrestrial feel.
Sometimes.
The clothing.
We must do what is requested of us.
Dangerous and disturbing this puzzle is.
You're using her as bait. I'm a Jedi.
A Jedi? What do you know?
Follow that speeder! You went that way.
This is a shortcut, I think.
Anakin! How many times have I told you?
Gotta go the power coupling.
We decided to come and rescue you.
Good job. Yeah. You know, Revenge of the Sith trailer. I mean, oh my God, this one. Bro, I can't explain to you guys what it was like in 2002 when I was 12 years old. Yoda does this in the theater. Bro, I remember where I was sitting. It was just such a freaking crazy moment. I remember the theater I was at. I remember which theater I was, like the actual theater in the theater I was in. Like, it was a time. It was a really crazy time. I remember the banners that they had up. You know, Anakin and Padme, Anakin looking this way, Padme looking that way. Dude, it was a time. I remember getting my popcorn. 12 years old. I wish everyone could have experienced it. It was a really cool time. Man, if I were born a bit sooner. Yeah, everyone went crazy. Bro, you know, and then what? Talking about it the next day at school. Oh my God. Oh. <Just stuck. laughs>
grabbing history and maybe going with it and becoming part of it and giving a story to our children.
It's going to be one of the many wonders of the world. There are now 8 wonders of the world. One of them being this movie.
We've been waiting since the last one came out for 16.
Bro, this is back before they had pre-sales for tickets and you could book your seat. People would line up. How many people remember that here? I know there's some people that are as old as me or older. There are people that would literally like bring their freaking campers and they would chill outside of the theater for days.
16 years. So this is a big thing. I mean, we've been waiting a long time. It's time to get back into it. It's the event of the whole thing.
I've been waiting 15 years since Return of the Jedi came out to see the prequel.
There's no way it's going to be a disappointment.
Are there any of you that think this is going to be a lousy movie? No!
I feel like, I don't know, like it's exciting. I'm going to be going to the first show of like Phantom Menace, and I don't know, that's all I can say. Thanks.
10 loved it, 7 liked it or thought it was okay, and 2 are no.
Fuck, it makes me emotional, dude. This is such a time, such a different time.
No longer Star Wars fans.
Fantastic.
Go see it as quick as you can.
It was better than all of them.
I think the lightsaber battles were the greatest.
It was good, dude. It was really good.
So worth it. So worth it.
They're gonna love it. They're gonna go nuts. It was amazing.
I couldn't get enough of it. I want to see it again already.
It was amazing. It was everything I thought it was gonna be and more.
Non-stop.
I can't wait to see it in 3 hours. I'll be lining up straight in the line again.
A lot of action, a lot of noise. It was cool.
I thought it was fantastic. Yeah, it was really good, must say.
I think it's going to be the hugest thing. The hugest thing.
It was intense. It was incredible. I loved it. It was awesome.
We got tickets for the 9 a.m. show. We're going to stick around and see it again.
I thought it was better than Return of the Jedi, personally, so.
Oh, damn. Dude. Holy shit. Can you imagine if Twitter was around back then?
Did a good job.
I like the special effects. I thought Lucas did a really good job.
I think that little Anakin Skywalker, and everyone's going to say it, stole that movie.
Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Oh, no.
God, I'd put my feet up if I could.
It's fantastic. Good special effects, good story. Lives up to the originals.
A very good movie. I believe the kids are going to love it.
It is worth every minute of it. We've waited 16 years for this moment. An unbiased opinion, how was the film?
I'd give it a definite thumbs up.
It was like new because all the guys were new and you didn't really know how everything fit together before.
So intense. I mean, my heart was beating. It's still beating now. And I just screamed, literally.
What do you think, Cole? Wet the white?
Yeah.
And who's your favorite?
Darth Maul.
Pandemonium. Everybody was out there.
Yeah, Darth Maul was my favorite when that was coming out.
Just screaming, yelling. When Lucasfilm logo came up and 20th Century Fox came up, that was the best.
I like Darth Vader.
Are you, okay.
He's a little kid. Do you want to marry him?
What?
You want to marry him?
You don't want to marry him?
It'll be a great movie 20 years from now. It'll be part of 6 great movies. Unless the next 2 really suck, but I don't think they will.
What'd you think of it?
I think it was an excellent movie. I think Mr. Lucas did a fabulous job. Special effects were wonderful, and the storyline was wonderful. And I'm gonna probably come back and watch it a couple more times.
But like that,
bro, what a
long-eared
time.
Alien dude.
What a time.
I mean, he always messed up, but he ended up helping his army and stuff. I thought it was pretty good.
Thumbs way down.
You didn't like it?
No, I think I deserve a public apology from George Lucas.
Damn. He's one of those Twitter guys.
Well, I've got to say, the Jedi have returned.
We're just fanatics out here waiting on Return of the Jedi. 3 years in the making. We're waiting for this.
Some people don't idolize Darth Vader like I do. See, I want him to get Luke.
And I think that that Luke will destroy Darth Vader.
I guess Darth Vader will die. I'm not sure. I hope he doesn't. I love his black.
I cast its spell on Chicago's sold-out audiences throughout the dawning hours.
Wow.
By 8 a.m., over 9,000 starstruck fans shared the new secrets of the Empire. The galactic faithful...
Going enough for me to main floor and balcony seating.
Bro, could you imagine how huge that was? Was anyone here during that time? Spam 1983 if you were here and you saw Return of the Jedi in theaters. I'm sure there's a lot of you. There's kind of you. There's like 4,500 people here.
Hold your own ticket as you enter the theater, please. Move it, move it, move it!
I remember the days when I would have to rush to the theater and get there early so I could get a good seat. Bro, I'd go to the theater and I'd be like, I mean, there was no phone, so I'd be like, yo, I'll go there early, I'll grab good seats. And then you like sit in your seat and while your friend goes and gets popcorn so that you don't lose your seat. It's just... Jesus.
We're the first four in.
What year were you guys born? What year was everyone born?
Here, people just invaded. It was a madhouse.
Get here first and be the first.
Hey, what's up, Jamie?
And wear your tennis shoes.
We
would do it again if we had to.
Finally, the wait is over. The fantasy unfolds.
It'll work. It'll work.
For some, the verdict is already in.
The biggest surprise was to see all of them together at the end playing pinochle and having a great time. I wished I was there, and I'm going to try to get a part of the next movie myself.
This has left me practically utterly speechless, actually, you know, but it was the best one ever.
The big surprise was seeing Darth Vader unveil himself to his son. It was very exciting.
Spoilers!
Biggest surprise? Well, I don't want to give it away to anybody.
Do you think it was worth coming to this late at night?
Yeah!
Good over to you.
Bro, that kid, wherever he's at now, probably remembers his night.
The movie was perfect. It was exactly the way it had to be. It was a fantastic movie, but it was good. It was really, really good.
Wait. It was a fantastic movie, but it was good? I'm going to start using that. It was a fantastic trailer, but it was good.
The first showing of Return of the Jedi at Highland Mall was at 11.
You guys want me to keep watching this? You want me to go back to the Acolyte trailer? I know I kind of went off of script here. Avatar The Last Acolyte reserving judgment. All I've known my entire life is Star Wars, but this trailer makes me wish they would just stop trying and not make any more content. It's not Star Wars. This guy is going to be a dope Jedi Master. The trailer doesn't give us a lot to work with. No, you know. Finally, we'll get a show explaining how Palps comes back. No shows explained it yet. Jokes aside, I really want to be excited, but I don't know. Yeah, I want to be excited, bro. The trailer has almost no information about the show. Your chat smells like mom's basement right now. Oh no, there's no white dudes. See it first. I don't think anyone's complaining about white dudes, bro. It's Star Wars. I don't think anyone gives a crap about color. I think they just want good Star Wars. Confuse my chat with that. Appreciate it. Thanks for the $5. Some of this reminds me of the scooter scene from Book of Boba Fett. Just, yeah, the outfits, I don't know, what the freak? Please do not return to the Acolyte trailer. Damn. You guys might like my little AI Yoda? That'd be cute. Oh. Whoa. I don't think I've ever watched this theater recording.
What's the mark here all riled up like that, huh, kid?
Wait. We gotta go to the I'm your father part. We have to.
No, I am the father.
Wait, no one said anything. Sometimes you don't get much of a reaction, I guess. What?
Oh!
That must have been a moment. The trailer almost had no... Oh, right. It's 50 years before... If it's 50 years before The Phantom Menace, is it possible that a young Palpatine at the end? And how about a youngling Mace in the beginning? That would be cool. I think they need to stay away from Jedi of the prequel trilogy. I think that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to keep away from it. If it's 50 years before The Phantom Menace, then Plagueis is very much in the scene. But also, he moves in the shadows, right? But the thing is that he would be very aware if there were any other dark entities that were around. He would sense them. He would feel them. He had 7 other apprentices around the galaxy that he was kind of vetting out to see which one would be the one. Palpatine, of course, took the role. But... that's why I say, like, it's, you know, you have to be careful when you're going back in time, because there are a lot of books, unless they want to say, like, hey, the books don't matter, which I guess they don't. I guess they don't now, unfortunately. And that really sucks, because the Plagueis novel is the best, I think, one of the best Star Wars books ever made. But, yeah, look, I mean, they're not playing the old story anymore. So, I mean, it is what it is. It is what it is, man. The martial arts scenes didn't work with Vader versus Reva and doesn't look much better here. 2 to 3 out of 10 trailer, mid as F show. What do you guys give the trailer out of 10? All the humans are chicks? Yeah. What looks weird to me is the High Republic robes. Let's go back to it.
Your mind.
Life. Balance. I see fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
That's pretty cool. Maybe we'll get some different force powers. I think Disney Plus is exhausting this volume screen technology. Say what you want about Andor, but that show honestly looks authentic to the eyes. I said it many times before, and this is what, you know, freaking Twitter won't show you. Andor was probably the best made Star Wars project to date. Looks like a fan film trailer to me. I can't stand that hairstyle they put on the black men in media who keep saying, yeah, let's use the Killmonger style. Coming from Kevin Terrell. Kevin's black, by the way. I know Kevin. Yeah, I would have rather he had a shaved head. I don't know. I just always think Jedi with shaved heads look ominous, mysterious, you know, monk-like. You know, they don't care about appearance. Doesn't matter to them. But yeah, you know. Whatever, man. Looks like the cast is off the streets of Portland and the homeless camps. What the? It feels so removed from what we know and not Star Wars, that it just looks like Disney's channel sci-fi murder mystery. Just a trailer. Hopefully it's good. Hopefully it's good too, man. All humans, so they can include very non-fictional ethnicity. Lemeo, that's crazy. All of those Jedi will have to die now. Everyone has to die in the show. Weird. I was told they had to do was put lightsabers and we'd all love it. We're upset because we want it to be good. There's a standard that's rarely met. I know, right? It's kind of weird, you know? Take away the bricks and screws, put lightsabers in, and you profit. Once again, doesn't feel like Star Wars. Have you heard George Lucas betrayed the fans today by endorsing Bob Iger and saying he fully trusts Disney? I don't know if he betrayed fans, but I think he... Because I know what he's said behind closed doors from people that know him. It's weird, bro. I would have loved if George was like, hey, look, I don't trust their leadership. But then again, that would hurt his stock. And I don't know, maybe he just really cares about his stock at this point. Yeah. What's up, MTQ? MTO Creations? What's up, Devlin? Thanks again. Also, from a small business owner like myself to another, dump this money into Theory Sabers, and I'll be buying one soon as the full site launches. Much love, brother. Much love, bro. Thank you so much. If Tenebris is not treated as canon, we will rage. The only white guy is a coward of a convict. Is there a white guy? I don't care, dude. I don't care if there's a white guy, a black guy, whatever guy, alien guy, woman. Whatever. I just want it to be good. I don't give a shit. Put a chick in it, make her gay, make it lame. All right, South Park. Dreadlocks, Star Wars, and Fade in Rings of Power. Woke shit. I'm not going to call it woke because of a haircut. I'm going to call it woke if it's woke. And so far I can't tell from a freaking trailer. I mean, I don't see too many dudes, but, you know, what do you expect when it's directed by Leslie Headland? It has potential that probably won't be realized. It feels like an uncanny fanfic about Star Wars who hasn't got the concept of Star Wars. No droids and barely any aliens. Yeah, well, what do you expect? What do you expect? I don't know, guys. I just can't get the taste of Leslie Headland out of my mouth. I want this to be good, but I expect mid. Looks like the same generic crap we've gotten for years. George makes sure to always have lots of aliens. He wanted the world to have lots of aliens. Not nitpicking at all, just facts. No, and that's the thing I really want to normalize again, is that, you know, being a fan is about nitpicking. It is about nitpicking, for sure. It's important to have opinions. And don't let anyone ever tell you, hey, you have to enjoy it and consume. That's some sort of, like, robot bullshit brainwashing that people, you know, these industries want you to think, that you can't think for yourself. You got to be able to think. You got to be able to be like, hey, look, I don't like this because of this, this, and this. Not just be like, oh, another product. Let me consume. No, dude, like, no, it's cool. Let's talk about it. What don't you like about it? What do you like about it? I think it's equally as wrong to blindfully hate something as it is to blindfully love something. And you're getting a lot of those people out there today because they just don't want to have an opinion because they're afraid of being wrong or offending someone. To that, I say, fuck it. Enjoy what you want to enjoy. Don't enjoy what you want to enjoy. Give reasons why. You're entitled to not like something. You're entitled to like something. Don't let anybody make you feel pressured to like or not like anything. Be yourself. Be authentic. In a world full of sheep, it's very rare today to be authentic and real. Let me tell you that. I get a lot of flack for it, but you know what? I sleep soundly at night because I know that my opinions are mine. I don't gotta twist them for anybody. Chick with the dagger is going to be recruited by the Sith. She might just be an assassin. Hey, Theory, just bought a saber from your shop. Just wondering if the blade is included. Yep, blade's included, man. You also get spare parts as well. Stay tuned for the full site's launch. A couple weeks away. plot that we're doing. And you'll see. I don't want to just, you know, like pop up a site and be like, buy these sabers. There's a lot we're doing, man. It's going to be the spot. The spot. Hey, Theory, when did chat get so cringe? Love you. I didn't see anything cringe. But then again, I'm just reading super chats. Don't know if it's been mentioned yet, but there's literally no white men. I have no hopes for this show. I'm so down with diversity, but not when it comes from outspoken woke directors. Yeah, I don't like Leslie Headland, that's for sure. But as for the white dudes, yeah, I don't notice any dudes in general, really. But I don't really care. Again, I don't care if it's a show that has only women. I don't care if it's a show that has only men or only aliens or only droids. If it's a dope show, it's a dope show. That's it. Plain and simple, man. That being said, yeah, obviously I want there to be dudes. I'm a guy. They should make a Rogue One kind of film with Death Star 2 plans. It would be cool if the Rebels boarded the Death Star and hacked the main terminal. Plo Koon spotted 55 seconds. Nah, I don't think it's Plo Koon. I mean, I'd be surprised. The Force, asexual Jedi, and abandoning family is just as evil as Sith. It's why I like Baylan and Shin. This trailer looks like Jedi propaganda. No, from what I understand, the High Republic is a time when the Jedi are more, compared to the prequel trilogy, they're more, it's like more of a rich time, like a real time, like where the Jedi aren't so, brainwashed with politics. What was your favorite part of Disney World? Star Wars Land in Anaheim was a bit underwhelming for me. Much love, bro. Disney World? Oh, just, you know what, bro? I didn't get to see the Tron ride. You know, all my life wanted to see the Tron ride. Didn't get to see it. Didn't get to see Pandora. So maybe next time, you know? Shout out Jay for not taking me. Thanks, bro. What was your, but yeah, I think, you know, the craziest part of Disney World was, most likely the fact that it was just so freaking big. It's like a city. Show will be poop. Same old woke Disney nonsense. Well, we'll see. Only sequel trilogy aliens are allowed. That Attack of the Clones youngling scene had no more aliens than this trailer. Do you think you're maybe jumping the gun based on a 2-minute trailer? I haven't really said anything, so. I haven't really even had a verdict about the trailer. So I don't know. What exactly am I jumping the gun about? You could let me know. People should keep in mind that George backing Boba as a Disney head. Bob as a Disney head isn't an endorsement of what Bob and Disney did to Star Wars. Two different things. That's kind of how I took it, too. Everyone afraid to say there's no men or aliens. I don't think anyone's afraid to say it. I just didn't think he would openly back Bob after his treatment of George's original sequel script and the Disney sequels. I thought there was bad blood with Bob. I'm sure it was to do with stocks. That's the way I took it. I don't think it had anything to do with Star Wars. Maybe I'm coping. Look at the likes and dislikes of the trailer. Oof.
Close your...
Yeah, but you know what, man? Like, I don't trust anything anymore on these. A company like Disney, man, they could freaking farm likes. I don't know. Who knows, bro? You can get everyone getting a memo at Disney that works at Disney, including the parks, to go and hit like on their new shit. I don't freaking know how it works. Hit like or you're fired. Ha ha. Who knows, bro? Or it's authentic. Maybe only 100,000 people really want to see it. 67,000 people don't want to see it. I mean, here we have 10,000 votes already. We have 52% that say yes, they like it. And we have 48% that say no, they don't like it. So, you know. So here they have how many votes? How many votes is that? 156,000 votes. And the percentage is... 2/3 like it. So yeah, what? 2/3 don't like it? No. What is that? What the fuck is that? What's the ratio there? It's a 2 to 3. So for every 3 people, 2 people like it. I don't know, bro. I make YouTube videos. I don't know. Someone tell George Lucas to blink twice if he needs help. To answer your question, there's currently a plan to take over Disney by Elon Musk, and that large shareholder dude, Bob, is panicking and asking for shareholder support. George is a sellout. Oh, that would make me very sad. He is. If this is 100 years before Menace, where would Yoda be? At the Jedi Temple. Ben Snow just sent it to you. Okay. Yeah. Here we go. Hey guys, check it out. Okay, episode list. June 4th, episode 1. Directed by Leslie Headland. Written by Leslie Headland. Episode 2, directed by Leslie Headland. Written by Jason McKelleff and Charmaine de Great. Okay, so we get 2 episodes June 4th. What day is that? Oh, crazy. A Tuesday, so that means our watch parties would be Mondays? Huh. Yeah. Weird. The show drops midnight on Tuesday. It's like 11:59 Monday. Okay. Episode 3, June 11th. Episode 4.
Yeah, I see.
Episode 5. June 26th, episode 6, July 2nd, episode 7, July 9th, episode 8, July 16th. Okay. Fine. Hey, Theory, keep up the great content. Looking forward to the watch party tonight. Oh, shit, the watch party is tonight. Wow, crazy. What's up, Darth Baba? Thanks, Zeke. What's up, Max? Diversity, the movie. Nikki Olson, what's up, Sir Darth? When are we going to retire the Killmonger haircut? Yeah. George and Bob are old friends. He trusts him more. I ain't much of a Star Wars guy. I know next to nothing about the lore, but I really like tuning into your videos every so often. Great content always. Thanks, dude. I hate how saturated and colorful Disney makes it. What, you want more of like a less saturated tone? Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, they needed a lot more wide-angle shots in this. There's, like, none. Oh, I see. Yeah, it's a little bright. It's pretty saturated. Yeah.
The boy will not pass the council's...
I love the way this scene looks. I always did.
Anakin will become a Jedi, I promise you.
Do not defy the Council Master, not again.
I shall do what I must, Obi-Wan.
If you would just follow the code, you would be on the Council. They will not go along with you this time.
You still have much to learn, my young apprentice.
A ship?
A
ship. Speeder.
How feel you?
Cold, sir.
Afraid, are you?
No, sir.
See through you. We can.
Be mindful of your feelings.
Your thoughts dwell
on your mother.
My thoughts dwell on your mother.
Afraid to lose her, I think.
What does that got to do with anything?
Everything.
Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger.
Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. He's like, whoa, you guys just took me off a desert planet, man. I don't care about this.
I sense much fear in you.
Train him. Train him properly, man.
The Force is strong with him.
He is to be trained, then?
All right, YouTube giving me the heads up that I'm using blocked content. Jesus, bro. Theory, like, here's my take, okay? I understand that we want to go and see other time periods and other places of the galaxy, but at that point, why call it Star Wars? It's just a sci-fi movie. Such a troublesome block. No. I mean, if George were to make something that were in this timeline, it would still be Star Wars. And that's just what Disney's trying to replicate. The issue is that I don't think they really are understanding to match the same sort of... I mean, look. Let me try to find two scenes. All right. I'm trying to find the same, similar looking scene. Here we go. What's up, Poppy Theory? What's up, Zabrak? Off the trailer alone, in my opinion, the show looks like cheap. Costumes don't hit. The music isn't immersed. Overall, filter looks lame. I thought all the same things. However, I'm really not one to just jump and say, this is the shit, this is blah, blah, blah. I haven't seen the product yet. It could very well be great. So far, I kind of have a sense of where it's headed. But I would agree with you. Wife gave birth yesterday and Theory drops reaction vids. Congratulations. Everyone give a big congratulations. Maybe a baby emoji for Darth Millennial. Hey, Theory, just bought my first saber from your shop, the Annie 3, and I was wondering if Blade is included. It certainly is. Thanks so much. Full site launch very soon. It's not about good or bad. What the F? That's literally what Star Wars is about. Yeah. I want to like this. The release of Fallout caught me and held me. This trailer has left me wondering. They could have done better somehow. The release of Fallout? What do you mean? Morgan Elsbeth, not intimidating. Shin Hattie, not intimidating. Loki Knife Girl, not intimidating. Second sister, who shit my pants. None of the characters look interesting at all. What's up, Showroom Sabers? 22 months, man. Two more in 2 years. Only three projects are indefensibly bad so far. The Last Jedi, The Rise of Skywalker, Mando Season 3, Book of Boba Fett, and Kenobi were disappointing but had moments. Everything else is good, great. Everything else is good, great. I think Force Awakens was lackluster. What other projects do we have? Okay, I guess you liked Andor. The only white dude will be the bad guy. Yeah, look, I don't... Hey, look, let me make the record straight here. I really don't care about color. I'm very mixed myself. I don't give a shit. I don't care. I don't care who's who, who's what gender. I don't... Just make a good story. That's all it comes down to. I couldn't give a rat's booty about anything else. Just make a good character. Can we watch the other short episode 2 teaser trailer that shows Obi-Wan in the beginning? There's another one that might be good to measure with. That's another one. Okay. This one? Tell your council that the first battalions are ready. And remind... Wait, that's not a trailer. Cinema reaction. Bro, that was a... I remember that. It was a crazy scene.
General Kenobi.
Ben.
Stay close.
If you can tweet me the short episode 2 teaser trailer, I can watch it. I'm really struggling to enjoy any Star Wars content after the sequels. It's a real shame. Keep doing what you're doing, man. I really appreciate it. Thanks, Ronan. People are mostly watching, hoping it gets better, and Disney seems fine with keeping us in that state. It's like we have Stockholm Syndrome, ATP. Kind of. It's like you just want to watch. It's funny. It's like you want to watch to see if it gets better, but then you also want to watch for the people who like are totally done to see how bad it is. So it's like, in terms of views and clicks and memberships, it doesn't make a difference. It doesn't make a difference if you like something or hate something. In terms of views, it makes no difference. If you like or dislike a video, it still counts as engagement. And that's the freaking thing. It doesn't matter if you dislike. It still counts as engagement. A video could get a crazy number of dislikes. YouTube sees it as, holy crap, people are engaging with this video. We're going to push it out more. And that's the trick. Right? That's the thing, is that it doesn't matter necessarily, even if it's good. Like, look at The Room, for example, the movie. You know, arguably one of the worst movies of all time, but in fact, it's now one of the most popular movies because it's so bad. You get it? Thoughts on Battlefield Classic. I made a video about it. Go check it out. Who knew the winner of Squid Game would make you become a Jedi Master? Liege. Oh, he's from Squid Game. Right. Also, jokes aside, I want more aliens, new aliens, even. Not 10 women to one random alien in an Outer Rim market. Look. I gotta be careful with what I say, because anything I say is turned against me. But at the end of the day, yeah, I don't really see a lot of dudes at all. But I mean, it's Leslie Headland, bro. What do you expect? And let me make the point. I don't care if it's all women. I don't care if it's all men. I don't care what. Just make it a freaking good story. I don't give a shit. I don't care. Matrix Reloaded meets High Republic. Star Wars should be its own thing. I'm open-minded to other takes, a la Andor. I don't want John Wick with lightsabers. I don't want John Wick with lightsabers. I just want a good story. That's all. Kenobi trailer was better. Look how that turned out. Kenobi trailer was better because it was Kenobi. This, we're starting from scratch. Revenge of the Sith teaser trailer for the win. Let's do it.
Before the Empire, a young Jedi named Darth Vader, who was a pupil of mine until he turned to evil, helped the Empire hunt down and destroy the Jedi Knights. Vader was seduced by the dark side of the Force.
Lord Vader.
It's not a real trailer, is it? This one is, I think.
The dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities.
Wait, is this real? Hold on here. It's so long, I can't tell. Oh, this one's real. Yeah, obviously. You notice the theme, right? That's what I'm talking about. Like every scene, wide angle shot of different planets, different scenes, world building.
The dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Is it possible to learn this power?
Not
from a Jedi.
The Council wants you to report on all the Chancellor's dealings.
That's treason.
We are at war, Anakin.
Very dangerous putting them together. I don't think the boy can handle it. I don't trust him.
I need your help, son.
I'm appointing you to be my personal representative on the Jedi Council.
You're on this council, but we do not grant you the rank of master.
What? Obi-Wan and the Council don't trust me.
Learn to know the dark side of the Force, and you achieve a power greater than any Jedi.
You're under arrest, Chancellor.
Are you threatening me, Master Jedi? Every single Jedi is now an enemy of the Republic. Do what must be done. Do not hesitate. Show no mercy.
Who could have done this?
Oh, jeez, I don't know.
By the dark side, young Skywalker.
Then so many people are going to be like, where is the comment? This isn't a trailer, this is a summary of the whole movie. Like, yeah, but everyone knows what happens. So, they're just like, hey, let's lean into it, screw it. I think this trailer released a lot of the film plot, yeah. But everyone knew it was going to happen anyway. You feel me? Bro. Even these trailers were so awesome.
Can have anything if he's willing to sacrifice. With your birth comes a solemn vow. You will have nothing. Your privilege is the dirt.
By the way, Vader Episode 2 is going to look better than this. Just saying. And 3. And that's saying a lot. Because this looks amazing.
Only ambition will guide you. The oath you swear, the promises you make, they are yours alone. Your freedom will be the wars you wage. Your birthright, the losses you suffer. Your entitlement, the pain you endure.
Dude, Arken was just very cool. Cool sabers. I'm bringing that back, dude. Vader Episode 2 and 3. You just watch. You just wait. The world will have to wait a little bit. Keep sending super chats. Keep helping fund it. Pause at 56 seconds. The Jedi on the far right kind of looks like Plo Koon from the back. Yeah, it kind of looks like not a Duros. What did I say, Duros? It's Cad Bane. My mistake. Keldor. Kind of looks like a Keldor. It is a Keldor, probably. I don't think it's Plo Koon, though. Only reason for the trailer is to show diversity. I mean, look, like, a lot of these dudes just look like regular dudes that you'd see at the grocery store. All right, like, I don't think, like, Obi-Wan doesn't look like a dude you'd see at the grocery store. Qui-Gon doesn't look like a dude you'd... Watch this be another bricks and screws situation. I'm gonna start going to the grocery store and being like, hey, are you in the Acolyte? Are you in the Acolyte? Why, yes, I am. Of course. I'm just here picking up some mushrooms for the Jedi. feels like Dune with sabers and the Force's basic sci-fi. No elements connect to Star Wars. World, family, we know and love. No eras, just don't feel like Star Wars. What's up, Vito? What's up, Jay? What's up, Firefox? So the lightsaber fighting literally has to be better than the prequels for this to even make sense, since before Disney, the prequels were all Jedi Prime. Yes. I used to hate 1 and 2, then Disney happened. 1 and 2? What do you mean, episode 1 and 2? Yeah, right? Kind of looks like people at Walmart. Desperately miss when everyone was this hyped for Star Wars. Are they? What's up, Larai? Riska, new member. What's going on? I completely get you. I was 13 years old in 1977. We were also blown away seeing this in theater. Months before, we were hooked when we saw the trailer. Wow, that must have been an amazing time. My dad saw it in theaters as well. He said it was like unlike any other time ever. You have to remember back then, there weren't, you know, sci-fi movies that were popping up left, right, and center like today. You know, there was no Transformers. There was no Marvel. There were, you know, CGI was like a very new thing. I've checked out Disney Star Wars for a while now, but the trailer definitely looked good. I hope they make it like Old Republic. Oh, okay, yo, Vito's into it. Like I said last night, hopes aren't high, yet the trailer was 50-50. You're right. Too many big-name actors, not enough aliens, a lot of yellow saber. Yeah. I mean, and I know people are waiting for me to rip it apart or to praise it. And I'll tell you guys right now, man, authenticity is my number one thing, just to be me. I don't like being fake. So I can't really judge it yet. Like, so far, I don't really know what to make of it. Like, okay, what are they going for? It's just, so far, like, the costumes I don't think are great. The Jedi look like run-of-the-mill dudes that you'd find at the grocery store. They don't really have, like, a presence to them. But again, it's a trailer. You know, there's too many things that are kind of keeping me in-world. I think this is only, like, the only wide shot that we have of it. And it's a forest. So... the thing with the prequel trilogy trailers, you know, you had shots that were all wide angle shots of different worlds, kind of right away establishing the different places and the world building and the fact that this is, you know, definitely somewhere completely different than Earth.
The boy will not.
You know what I mean? Everything was just, like, different.
It was just before dawn. They came out of nowhere.
Do you have any idea who's behind this attack?
We will find out who's trying to kill you, Padme. I promise you.
I think we just have to accept the fact that it's never going to be like it was. And we have the movies, 1 to 6, and that'll always stand. And then now we have stuff that they're trying to make a thing. And, you know, all we can do is appreciate it for the good parts and dismantle it for the parts that aren't congruent with the Star Wars that we grew up with. That's kind of my modus operandi. I'm only looking forward to Bricks and Screws Season 2. I'm sure you are. Hey, got a saber question. Any chance of a Darth Nihilus saber? Planning on buying a saber in June. Much love. Off subject, I apologize. No, not at all. I mean, as you know, I'm really working hard on Theory Sabers, and it won't disappoint. So we're a couple weeks away. I mean, we're pretty much ready to launch this week, but we're a couple weeks away, finalizing some things. And, yeah, every saber you could possibly want, inspired by many different characters. Yeah, you'll have everything. Trust me. You know, with having, this sounds arrogant, but it's really not. Having the world's biggest Star Wars channel, you know, I can't just make a website that has, hey, you come here and buy these sabers. You know, it has to be something truly special, give you a truly special experience, and be in something that's, once again, using the same word, congruent with the biggest Star Wars channel in the world. You know, there's over 1.1 billion views here, and I owe that to you guys. Just, you know, to wrap your head around it, like, there's a lot of eyes that come to the channel. I don't want to just offer garbage just to make a buck. So that's the thing with, you know, growing a channel. I didn't want to make a Star Wars channel to make money. I don't want to sell sabers to make money. Of course I want to make money, but that's not the main goal. I want to do, like how I made a channel, I want to make a channel the way I would want to make it. I want to see content what I want to see. And that's how I go about everything in my life. I imagine you snoring like the trailer music. Yeah, trailer music wasn't anything special. Lost my spot. Revenge of the Sith teaser trailer for the win. Kenobi trailer was better. Look how that turned out. How many people will get stabbed and live in this show? But that's something they gotta change, bro. Are we gonna see young Palpatine do it? It's possible. I don't think he's around. If it's 100 years, I thought it was 50 years. This is Disney. No, oh, you know what? I think it was the end of the show is 50 years before The Phantom Menace. Or am I totally incorrect? Incorrect. This is Disney. Nobody dies in Disney. Shogun, you must watch. Shogun is a very good series. I haven't seen it. I haven't had time. If I'm being honest, the best part of the trailer was seeing Trinity back in the Matrix. Mods need slow mode in chat, dear Theory. Nah, let it be fast. Theory, you're great, but your fan base is toxic as hell. Bro, that's the Star Wars fan base. Don't label it as my fan base. My fan base has a lot of really amazing... I would argue my fan base has the most pure people, kind-hearted people in all of Star Wars. Anyone who's toxic, I mean, that you can't throw that onto me. That's just anyone who's toxic. And also, this whole toxic bullshit is just for a bunch of softies. All right? People have opinions. You may not like it. It doesn't mean they're toxic. The second you have a mid or different opinion other than blatant hate, chat starts devolving into an absolute nightmare. Thanks, mods. Leslie equals awful person who covered for Harvey Weinstein. Theory, are we gonna not act like everyone in this show is mostly women? No, they are. Did you expect anything different with Leslie Headland? And again, I don't care. I mean, I wish it was more equal, but did you expect anything different? I mean, I came into this thinking that it's going to be exactly like that. And again, I don't care. I just want it to be a good show. I just don't understand why they keep pushing stuff that no one asks for. Well, to be honest, I think, you know, a Jedi show a couple hundred years or whatever, 100 years before The Phantom Menace is actually a pretty cool idea. Depends how they do it. Folks see minorities and immediately say it's woke. I don't think it's that simple. Because the prequel trilogy had minorities. They had a lot of them. Do you think Plagueis will be in it? I mean, if he's not mentioned, it's going to be kind of weird. If Tenebris isn't mentioned, it's kind of weird. You know, there should be like, there is another Darksider out there who's very powerful and watching over. We have to be silent or something like that. It's something like that. This doesn't have the feel of Star Wars, but I'm excited to see something new with a new vibe. Hopefully it does things right. Yeah, hopefully. Yo, man, the trailer looked okay to me, but 30-minute episodes. You think the yellow sabers are off-world temple guards? People were saying they were orange. No, they're just yellow sabers. What do you mean 30-minute episodes? These episodes are 30 minutes? Would you hear this? People are pretty split on it, whether they think it'll be good or not. I'm looking forward to seeing for myself. Hope it's worth the wait. Thanks, Theory, for all you do. Hey, thanks, Charlie. But this is the High Republic era, no? All the book art depicts it being light and colorful the same way. Yeah. The O is an eclipse. Collider just reported an interview with Hedlund about the show and trailer. She talks about the EU. Yeah. Okay. Theory, my man, been a bit since I've been able to catch you live. Been watching, been waiting all day to see, hear your opinion on the trailer. I think it looks pretty good, but I'm going to stay cautious. Yeah, well, you know, that's kind of my movement with everything Disney Star Wars is that I hope it's good, but I stay cautious. Yeah, I mean, bro, like, ain't much I can really say from a trailer. I can't be like, oh, I can't deduce that this is going to be garbage. I can't deduce it's going to be great. I mean, there's things I can notice. Like, I noticed that it feels very claustrophobic already. I don't feel like there's too much world building already. I feel like it's primarily a female dominant show, which, again, I don't care. I just want it to be a good show. I feel like the costumes aren't that great. I feel like there aren't many aliens. What else? That's it. But I also feel like the premise is interesting, that there is a there's someone killing Jedi in a time when Jedi are like the end-all be-all kind of godlike beings. You know, it's kind of like a murder mystery, literally. We gotta figure out who it is, and we gotta stop them before they kill more of us. So. I couldn't decide on what saber to get, so I bought two. Thanks, dude. Hey, guys, you know, I hate shamelessly plugging this stuff because nobody else is going to do it for me. I got to do everything myself, obviously, what YouTube is. But if you guys could go ahead and try to get this to 20,000 followers, I mean, there's over there were over 5,000 of you here. There's over 3,000 right now. If you can go to Theory Sabers and just give it a follow. Cheap Trick, I'm turning 34 on Thursday. It's my birthday. I'd really love it if I could hit 20,000 around that time. You know, within a couple weeks. That'd be dope. We're working really hard on creating something truly special for the community. And I'm really trying to grow my brand. And I'd love your help. I'd really appreciate your help. I'm doing my best. And, you know, all the money from these Sabers goes right back into Vader Episode 2. I haven't collected a dime. So, and into the products and into everything else that we're doing. So if you can go ahead and give it a follow, I really appreciate it. We're all busting our ass off for this, for the launch. The launch is going to be truly amazing. Don't look at the site right now. The site is, it's pathetic, but, you know, there's still 5 products available. You can go grab those right now. But anyways. To all the shills, don't forget to breathe with Disney's Johnson in your... Make Star Wars cool again. The target audience never changed. Just finished Jedi Survivor and it didn't even feel like Star Wars. Force Unleashed 1 and 2 was a little over the top, but they felt Lucas. Force Unleashed 1 and 2 was great. Jedi Survivor felt a little weird compared to Jedi Fallen Order. Fallen Order felt great. What's up, Timify? Hey, Shaka, bro. What's up? What's up, man? Chilling. Watch elevator video that just dropped. So funny. What's up, Same? What's up, Rossi? Groceries, dude, you're ruthless? Not really. They basically went to the Amazon grocery store and did their Do you think we'll get any old Republic shows? Yeah, eventually. I want Mandalorian season 4, 5, 6, and 7. It's the only thing in Disney Star Wars that has been truly outstanding, except for 3. That snow planet in the first trailer is Ilum. You think? I don't know. We got 12,430 votes asking, did you like the trailer? 53% say yes. 47% say no. Look at these stats here.
Close your eyes.
95,000 people like the trailer. 72,000 people don't like the trailer.
Not good odds.
Love the channel, brother. Thanks for all the content, as always. Worst part of the trailer is it felt nothing. I felt nothing 5 out of 10. She said in that interview it's 30-minute episodes. Oh. Trailer was okay. Not good, not bad. But I do think that the poster released yesterday was pretty rad. Check it out if you haven't already. Yeah, the one with the blood. I have a theory. The Sith in this are failed apprentices before Palpatine, and they're just probing the Jedi ahead of what comes later. No, I truly do buy into the original theory or the original leak about it being, the sister that was left behind in the village that tries to take revenge and kill all the Jedi. I think that's pretty cool. I'd do the same. Like, bro, you guys suck. You took my sibling and then you let my parents die and my whole village. See you later. I'm going to dedicate my whole life to destroying you. That's what I would do. I think anyone would do that. Well, not anybody, but most people. All right, let's see the comments. Close your eyes, alien, I can't. Wait.
I see fire.
It was good. All right, that was a good one. That was a good one. Oh, that's good. All right. Next one. As long as the episodes don't stream off Azure service, we should. Youngling, I see fire, teacher. For fuck's sake, here we go. Youngling, I see fire, master. Wrong universe. I see fire. Okay, this kid is a lost cause. What do you see? I see the chosen one storming the Jedi temple and killing all of us. Close your eyes. What do you see? I see myself shaking hands with Dumbledore. I want the house cup for Griffin. For these are amazing. There better be Snoop in this, or this ain't the Republic. When did you guys get so funny? 108 uses the Force to open a door, which looks like they opened that way anyway. The way a kid pretends to use the Force when the supermarket door is open. I'm telling you, grocery store. It's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Yeah, that's funny. Someone comes and be like, sir, the doors are automatic. They open that way. Anyways, it doesn't look like any war is going around. Like, it's like some top secret door. Just walking around in the background like, oh, yes, hey, Dale, how's it going? I'm pretty good, John. I'm pretty good. Yeah, I'm having a good time. Yeah, how about you, Kathy? Oh, yeah, I'm doing great. Yeah, what's that person doing? They're just trying to be a Jedi. I don't know what's going on. quote, impossible. The Sith are extinct. They have been for nearly a millennium. End quote. Ki Adi Mundi should know. It's in the prime. I have a bad feeling about this. This show feels like it's very, very aware that it's being watched. Like, every time it makes a creative decision, it elbow nudges the audience and goes, see what I did there? Oh, that's a really good way of explaining it, actually. Plot twist, this series is a Star Wars Jedi training simulator in the Matrix. Youngling, I see fire. James Taylor, and I see rain. I love the part where Trinity says, you think that's air you're breathing? Don't look at it, Marion. Keep your eyes closed no matter what happens. Trust me, Marion. What do you see? I see Trinity. I see Trinity. Did you ever hear the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise? Not in this one. Jedi, close your eyes. What do you see? Youngling, I see the end of everything by season's end. 130, Star Wars fans joining forces at Comic-Con be like... Yeah, all with a theory saber. Plug. Where are we? She does more Matrix in one trailer than the entire Matrix 4. That's true. Man forgot to tell me I can open my eyes. I watched the whole thing with my eyes. Oh, wait. Close your eyes. What do you see? The cult of personality. Someone is killing Jedi. Me. Excellent. This looks and sounds like a fan film. Youngling, I see fire. I'll kill you in your sleep. I just put two and two together. Oh, that's great. Dude, I think that's my favorite comment right there. W. Jedi Master, what do you see, Youngling? I see a web of green Matrix code. The first 15 seconds of them describe current Disney Star Wars. Your eyes can deceive you. Okay, Neo. I love the part where Trinity says the Matrix cannot tell you who you are. 129, is it Darth Jar Jar? Let's make another poo-poo caca. I'm going to need guns, lots of guns. Gi-Hun survives Squid Game to become a Jedi. Close your eyes, what do you see? I see fire by Pink. Somehow Palpatine returned before he was born. I see a far superior story called Dune. Ouch. What comes into my mind, DEI hires? Trinity is back as a Jedi Knight. She is going to lead the investigation, maybe as she is prominent throughout this trailer. Close your eyes, but if you close your eyes...
What?
The Asian Master was a Sith Lord the whole time. Who would have thought? I love the part where Arnold says, come with me if you want to live. No way they got Killmonger haircut in Star Wars 2. So many lightsabers to add to my collection. The reviews of this are going to be gold. It's been so long since I've seen so many Jedi huddled up together. Almost feels fan-made to me. It isn't about good or bad. It is about Disney Plus subscriptions. That's true. I see fire, I see rain, I see sunny days that I hope will never end. Yo, Trinity is a Jedi. I see fire. That's just Anakin fulfilling the prophecy. Don't mind him. Someone is killing Jedi. What else is new? This used to be a multi-billion dollar franchise. Close your eyes. What do you see? I see darkness. Plot twist. It's called the High Republic because all the Jedi smoke weed. They snuck in Killmonger haircut into Star Wars 2. The lightsaber better not bounce like a baseball bat. You know the baseball bat thing? I always thought that's just Obi-Wan not wanting to traumatize Leia, so he's just like giving him a little slash to kill him. That's how I took that, but I mean... Impossible. The Sith are extinct. They have been for nearly a millennium. Yeah. Well, so that's what they do, man. They create these stories, and then they're going to have to kill everybody. Otherwise, it's not going to make sense. Everyone has to be dead. Close your eyes. What do you see? Master Chief clapping someone. I hope we get a mention of Dagan Gera. He was a High Republic Jedi. Yeah. But I think he was... few hundred years before. Gotta love how they managed to break canon just from the idea of this show. The Sith have been extinct for a millennium. Episode 1, Phantom Menace, meaning no Jedi has taken notice of the existence of the Sith during that time. Acolyte takes place 100 years before that, and clearly Jedi are taking notice of her from that trailer. Congratulations, you haven't done basic homework. Yeah, well, I mean, it's... very simple. They're going to have everybody who sees a red lightsaber will have to die. It's as simple as that. as simple as that. And if someone, like, you know, the whole Reva thing, how she went away scot-free, knowing that Anakin has a son named Luke and where he lives, I mean, that is the one of the biggest lore-breaking things in Star Wars. Not to mention, of course, Obi-Wan and Vader fighting again, but if any Jedi in this show ends up seeing a red lightsaber and lives, that is a major breach of lore. And that would completely... It's all legends anyway, who cares? That's just the way I see it. If it's going to be like that, I mean, you know. Come on. Trailer over here, can I open them now? Oh my god, that's funny. I see a silhouette of a man. What? The Sith have been extinct from Lenin. Yeah, okay, well, I'm going to make a quick video on that because it's like a recurring comment I see. And it's very true. I don't disagree with it. Is that the island that Luke was on at The Last Jedi? I think so, yeah. Are you saying I can ignore Star Wars? No, Neo. I'm saying when you know that, when you know what the Acolyte is, you won't have to. Oh, please, that was... Oh, that's hilarious. These comments, man. Comments made my day. Will you post more Jedi on Instagram from Vader 2 and what's the name of the Wookiee? I'm thinking Mamoru. I really like that name. It was really good. Really, really good. Yeah, I can show you some stuff right now, actually. So... We did a full, like, rebuff of Vader, so he's a lot more stocky and jacked. We essentially took Dave Prowse's body, and we modeled. So all the models, these aren't, like, Battlefront 2 models or models are from anyone else. We're making them from scratch. So we're making these models. These are all mine, right? So here's another picture of Vader without his cape and armor. So you can see he's quite thick build, bulky, he's stocked, he's jacked. So that's really something we're going for. As for the Jedi, I mean, it's something that's really important is the fact that we have a lot of aliens. And so, you know, we're designing a lot of different ones. Here's a Nautilin. Just, you know, your typical Nautilin. A bunch of different angles. Of course, these are not finished. Keep in mind. You know, we're just playing around with some different things here. That's just a selfie of me. You know, of course, this is not done either, but this is just another design we have for another Jedi. Every Jedi, you know, we want to keep it looking extremely different, you know, so it's not all humans. It's Star Wars after all, so it has to be a lot of aliens. A Zabrak right here. Here's another angle of her. So, you know, we're making good progress, man. Making good progress. All right. Looks pretty great. Looks pretty good. So, yeah. Doing our best, bro. Ain't playing around. For those who make stuff in CGI, characters and models, whatever, and it's so hard to make hair. And when you have a character that's covered in hair, it's very difficult, and I feel like the guys nailed it. The team nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. Did a great job. So, This is Bob. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that looks good, yeah. Thank you. Hayden Christensen is no David Prowse. Well, yeah. Meaning? Vader 2 and 3 is the only Star Wars I'm excited for. Thanks. Yeah, you know what? We're... I'm not playing around, bro. That's for sure. So, yeah. Hey, guys, all your money, everything that you guys send to me goes right into the film. It's a $500,000 project, and I'm one person funding it. So I know I say it a lot, but it is quite a lot to take on. So I appreciate everything that you guys do. Finally, a show about the Vespa gang. Oh God. I love the part where they said someone's killing the Jedi. You could see Mickey's ear poking out from behind a tree. Bro, this feels like Rings of Power type series. Ouch. Ouch. Hey, shout out for 17K. Thanks, guys. Still 3,000 of you here, so, you know, there's no reason why we can't hit 20. Waiting. All right, let's give it one more watch here.
Close your eyes. Your eyes can deceive you. We must not trust them. Tell me what comes into your mind.
Life. Balance. I see fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
The remote moment reminded me of Queen of the Damned. You guys remember that? This one right here. This one.
This isn't about good or bad. To use it.
What is that?
Yeah, we'll see what it's about. All right, boys and ghouls, I'm going to go and do the breakdown real quick. Give my thoughts on a few things about Plagueis being in it, Tenebris being in it, how the Jedi need to die. Everyone who sees that red lightsaber got to die. And that's it. So, yeah. Thanks for chilling with me. Let me know if you're excited. Let me know if you're pumped or if you're not. That's totally fine, too. And at the end of the day, never let anyone's opinion sway yours. You have the right to have any opinion you like. You love it. If you hate it, tell me why. Love you all. Have a great day. May the Force be with you. I'll see you for the watch party later tonight. Could this lead to Darth Plagueis? Fat Mace eats everything in canon. Wouldn't mind trying out for the shill role for your future podcast. We don't need one of those. There's a rumor Hayden might be Silver Surfer in Fantastic Four. I see dead people, but they don't know they're dead. Okay. Great. Later, boys. Love you. May the Force be with you. See you tonight.